In this lecture, we will learn how to support system-wide light or dark appearance with Swift UI. We are going to create adaptive color sets and prepare some specific graphics for dark mode as well. Select the Assets catalog in the Project Navigator. Right-click or Ctrl-click on the empty part of the center panel. Choose New Color Set in the contextual menu. Rename the color set to Color Black Transparent Light. Select the color and open the Inspector panel with the Attributes tab. Set the red, green, and blue sliders to 0. It will create a pure black color. Change the opacity of this black color to 25%, which makes it semi-transparent black color. We will use it for creating shadows later on. Next, let's create another color set similarly as we did before. Rename it to Color Black Transparent Dark. Select the color and set the color's sliders to 0 again. And finally, the opacity will be 80% this time. This transparent black color will be great for creating strong shadows here and there in this project. We are going to create the third color set, but this time we will make it support the light and dark mode. So let's create another color set and rename it to Color Appearance Adaptive. Select the color and in the Attributes tab under the Appearance, click on the drop-down menu. By choosing the Any Light and Dark option, we tell Xcode that we want our color to adopt in different environments such as light and dark appearance. Click on the button option and you will see that in the center there are three slots for our color set. We will configure the appearance variants we want to modify right now. In general, we use the Any Appearance variant to specify the color value to use on older systems that don't support dark mode. We will leave it white now. The light appearance is also white, but in the dark appearance, we want it to be black. Select the dark color slot and set its color sliders to 0. Using this unique color set, we will create some interesting UI elements in the Avocado Facts and Avocado Ripening section. Let's continue with creating another adaptive color. It will be more obvious for you how this configuration works. Create another color and rename it to Color Green Adaptive. Choose any light and dark options in the Appearances attributes. Change the color input method to 8-bit hexadecimal. Enter the 167942 after the hashtag. This color set will contain medium and light green colors. Select the Any Appearance color variant and copy it with the Command plus C shortcut to the clipboard. Then select the Light Appearance color variant, which is white now, and paste the green color by Command plus V shortcut. Finally, select the Dark Appearance and give it to the following hex color values: C8D899. As you will see, when we start using this color set, the medium green variant will show up in the light mode and the light green variant will show up in the dark mode. We will add the rest of the color set assets to our project by drag and drop them from the Resources folder. Open a new Finder window and navigate to the Resources folder on the desktop. Open the Colors folder and select all of the three color assets in it. Then drag and drop these folders to the Assets panel as I show you. You will see these new regular colors in the Assets panel. Select all of the colors by clicking on them. Then, by right-click or Ctrl-click on them, a contextual menu will appear for us. Choose New Folder from Selection. It will insert all of the color assets into a new folder. Rename it to Colors. After dealing with the adaptive colors, we are going to configure some images for both light and dark interfaces. This part is more visual and exciting than the previous one, for sure. First things first, create an empty folder and name it to Launch Screen. Navigate to the Resources folder on the desktop again. Open the Launch Screen folder. It's crucial that you follow me now, step by step. Select only the greenish background images. Then drag and drop these JPEGs to the Launch Screen as I do. Choose any light and dark options in the Appearances attributes. Now you will see new empty slots for the image variants. Copy and paste the images from the Any to the Light Appearances slots. This time we have got not only 1x, but 2x and 3x image sizes as well. Then go back to the Launch Screen folder and drag and drop the bluish backgrounds respectively to its empty slots. Our next task is to create new image assets for the headers of the Avocado Recipes app. Let's create an empty folder and name it to Avocado Headers. Navigate to the Resources folder in a Finder window on the desktop. Then open the Avocado Headers folder. There are a bunch of graphics in it. It's important to select only the images with a green background. Then drag and drop these graphics into the Avocado Headers as I show you. This time there are only 1x graphics, but we will use these big images universally. Select all of the 6 images and choose any light and dark options in the Appearances attributes. The next steps are self-explanatory, in my opinion. Copy and paste all images from the Any to the Light Appearances respectively. After finishing with it, go back to the Avocado Headers folder. Watch out the file's names, then drag and drop the specific graphics to its match one. So slice 1 dark goes to the slice 1 image and so on. The image order is important because we want our header continues when we scroll in horizontal. Finished? Good job! Our last task is to create an adaptive tab icon sets for this app. Let's create an empty folder and name it to Tab Icons. Navigate back to the Resources folder on the desktop. Then open the Tab Icons folder. There are a bunch of graphics in it. Select all of the 4 PDF icons with black linear strokes. Then drag and drop these graphics into the Tab Icons as I do. After that, in the Inspectors, Resizing, select the Preserve Vector Data option. Then choose any light and dark option in the Appearances. Copy and paste the icons from the Any to the Light Appearances respectively. After finishing with it, go back to the tab icons folder. Again, watch out the file's names, then drag and drop the specific icons to its match one. So, tab icon avocado dark goes to the tab icon avocado icon, and so on. These tab icons will change their appearance automatically from black to white when an iPhone or iPad switches from light mode to dark mode. These tab icons will change their appearance automatically from black to white when an iPhone or iPad switches from light mode to dark mode. And that's it. This whole preparation process might seem to be quite intimidating, but it's worth dealing with it because later on these images will change automatically when the device switches from light mode to dark mode and vice versa. See you in the next lecture.